The topic of the video is Redox equation for a free particle which is moving in the relativistic region of speeds. For a particle which is moving with the speeds closer to the speed of light in vacuum, the relationship between its energy and momentum is given by E square is equals to C square P square plus M square C power 4. Where P is momentum of the particle and E is energy of the particle and C is the speed of light in vacuum. And if you rearrange that equation, we can write E is equals to plus or minus and then square root of the thing in the square square bracket. And we can call this as equation number 1. Dirac defined that the quantity in the square bracket, which is the C square P square plus M square C power 4, as something equal to square bracket C into alpha X PX plus alpha Y PY alpha Z PZ, where PX, PY, PZ are the components of linear momentum of the particle, and then alpha X, alpha Y and alpha Z are the certain things which are which can be actually found, and then plus B times C square and all raised to power 2 as equation number 2. And the reason why he took it this way is because if you take it this way, then we can see that when we replace E by its operator's form, which is IH cut into dou by dou T, and then PX by its operator's form, which is minus IH cut into dou by dou X, and then PY and PZ similar kind of expressions, we will see that this equation number 1 will actually turn into some differential equation, partial differential equation, where it will be linear both with respect to time and also space. And if you actually expand the RHS, I mean the right hand side of equation number 2, which is square of the thing which is in this square bracket, so we can write the thing in the square bracket into the itself. And if you do that, and then if you actually kind of write C square as a common factor, because it will come for as a common factor for the thing when you multiply the thing in this open bracket with the thing in this open bracket here, and then you know what, we need to keep the order intact. So if you do that way, then we'll see that it will include all these cross terms and taking the commutator between alpha i's and p i's as zero, and knowing that the commutation between any pair of px, py, pz also zero, we can actually get all the thing in this form. And if we actually compare the LHS, I mean the left hand side and right hand side of this equation, then we'll notice that alpha x squared is equals to alpha y squared and alpha z squared and beta squared, all of that should be equal to 1, and alpha x plus alpha y plus alpha y alpha z and similar kind of expressions, all of them should be actually equal to 0, and alpha x into beta plus beta into alpha x and similar kind of expressions for y and z components also, they should be equal to 0. That means these alphas and beta, they cannot be simply some scalars, but they should be some kind of matrices. So if you actually combine those equations number 1 and 2, we can write the energy can be plus or minus and then the square bracket within that C into open bracket alpha x px plus alpha y py plus alpha z pz plus p times squared. And if you take only the positive sign of this, and if you replace E with its operator form, which is IH cut into dou by dou T, and then PX with its operator form minus IH cut into dou by dou X, and similar kind of operators form for PY and PZ into the above equation, and then if you operate the thing on some wave function psi RT, then we can write this equation, and this is what we refer or we call as the Dirac's equation for relativistic free particle. That's it in this video, and thanks for watching.